8 knockouts or technical knockouts between these two opponents. And introducing first, standing on my left and fighting from the blue side of the cage, she is trained as a Muay Thai fighter with good striking skills at 5 feet 9 inches tall. She weighed in at an even 135 pounds. Her professional record, 3 wins with 2 losses, 2 of those coming by way of technical knockout. Fighting out of Pleasant Hill, California, ladies and gentlemen, here is Leslie, the Peacemaker Smith.
Smart timing, Les.
Her opponent tonight, fighting from the red side of the cage, also a prolific striker. At 5 feet 9 inches tall, she weighed in at 135 and one half pounds. Her record, 7 wins with 5 losses, all but one of them coming by way of knockout or technical knockout. Training with Minnesota Martial Arts Academy. And here to Kansas City from St. Louis Park, Minnesota, how about a big welcome for Kaitlin Young? Greg Franklin is your referee for this bout again scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Fighters, you've been given your instructions back in the locker room. I want a good, clean fight. Obey my commands at all times. Do I have any questions out of the red corner? Any questions out of the blue corner? Touch gloves, come out fighting.
You know, at the top of the telecast, Julie, we talked about you being the 2005 Hook and Shoot Women's Grand Prix Champion and what Jeff Osborne has done for the sport of women's MMA. Well, Kaitlin Young was the 2007 Hook and Shoot Women's Grand Prix Champ with 3 brutal knockouts in one night, including a highlight reel head kick KO of former Strike Force Women's Bantamweight Champion Misha Tate.
Yeah, when you talk about high athletic ability in this sport, Kaitlin Young tops the list. She's incredibly athletic, incredibly strong, and her movement is really, really sharp.
Young in the black and white, Smith in the black and red. Young also known, of course, for being Gina Carano's opponent in the very first female MMA event on Primetime Network TV, Elite XC Primetime, back in May of 2008. And no feeling out process here, Mo.
Nah, man, she comes from the Diaz camp. She trains with them, and she goes out there and fights high volume, and we see it right now.
Talking about Leslie Smith in the blue tape around her wrist. Kaitlin Young also going at it. This is definitely Lover's affair, and there's the takedown. Young on her back now.
Wow, Kaitlin does a really nice hip switch there for an armbar attempt.
Both of these ladies known for their striking power. 6 of Young's 7 wins come via form of knockout. That's the most, by the way, on this Invicta card. The 6 wins via form of KO, while Leslie Smith, 2 of her 3 wins have come by way of a knockout or TKO.
Caitlin's hiking those legs up, trying for a high guard position.
There's the triangle. The body triangle, and just really wanting to control Smith here, Mo.
Trying to control her posture. Control her posture in the head, and they can't land any significant strikes.
I think Caitlin's looking for a position to get back to her feet. Oh,
Smith not giving it her, but she does bounce up and delivers a knee as well. Flashes a jab, body kick.
That knee hurt her.
Yeah, if I were Caitlin, I would avoid more body kicks at the moment and start attacking the legs or the head. Oh, beautiful overhand.
There's a left, a nice jab, oh, uppercut from Smith, who just swings wild and gets caught with that right hand from Young. Oh, a nice body shot by Smith, and she continues to go to the body.
Caitlin tying up in the clinch. Her clinch is very, very strong. Let's see what she does with it.
Looks for the collar tie, maybe wants to go to the full tie plum, and now just delivering knees. Oh, a nice crossing elbow strike.
I'd like to see Smith try to take it to the ground again. On the other hand, this is really exciting, so maybe I don't want to see her take it to the ground.
Yeah, Smith is far more, she's far more effective when she's coming forward throwing the volume.
Yeah,
but when she's backing up, she's just getting picked apart.
Yeah.
Just past the midway point of the opening round, it's been a very exciting start to this bantamweight bout between Kaitlin Young and Leslie Smith. No feeling out process. Smith coming forward with a right hand. There's a push kick.
Back that leg, Kaitlin, back that leg.
Nice kick.
Inside leg kick from Young.
It's really hard to walk the next day when you get kicked in the leg from Kaitlin Young.
So you're saying usually if you face Kaitlin Young, you're not going to be doing the Dougie later that night?
I wasn't.
Mo, do you do the Dougie?
Nah, man, we don't Dougie no more.
That's old.
We hit the South Dallas swag. That's a new dance right now.
It's Ariel Helwani's favorite dance, the Dougie. There's a body kick from Young. And Smith comes back.
Smith is doing a really great job just being gritty and just getting right in there and getting the shots that she wants. And then,
oh wow. Wet flurry from Smith, but then it's Young who stops it with a right and a left.
I like how Young's throwing combos and finishing the leg kick.
Yeah, she's
or body kick.
Really beautifully timed Muay Thai.
But Smith nice. Again whims in with the left hook and a right hand as well. Not willing to give Young any room. You're just staying in the pocket.
I saw, you see the fake teeth, attempt the teeth to throw some shots.
Close the teeth, the equivalent nice. Of a leg jab.
Foot jab.
And foot jab, you're right.
Kaitlin does a good job of attacking on the left and then attacking on the right. Moving her strikes high to low, high to low.
The last time I checked, the foot is attached to the leg.
Not understanding because that's what.
No, you're right. A foot jab, yeah. What, how they use it for sure.
One of the guys, AKA, his name's Jasper. He's a Thai fighter. He goes, foot jab, foot jab.
Nice. That's the teeth. One of the primary weapons in Muay Thai.
I think Smith's leg kicks would be a little bit more effective if she struck first. Nice flurry.
Earth, and she mixes it up with some kicks. There's the Thai plum from Young with the knee, but she gets back to the defense. So a very competitive nice opening round here.
Nice elbow.
The tactic elbows at these ladies now. Neither one of them wants to give space.
A smorgasbord of strikes, and they are mixing it up here in round one. The final few seconds of what has been an electrifying start nice. Between Leslie Smith and Kaitlin Young. They battle to the bell. The bell in round two is underway. And immediately Smith again taking the center of the cage, backing up Young in the black and white, Smith in the black and red.
Smith has good head movement on that right hand, getting right out of the range of that hook there.
I like the pressure she's bringing. But she needs to keep going forward and have more confidence in her jab.
I absolutely agree with you. Kaitlin's winning the exchanges when she moves forward.
Smith coming off the loss to Gomez. Her only other loss was to Carrie Vera at Bellator Fighting Championships in May of 2009. Carrie Vera, of course, the wife of UFC veteran Brandon Vera. And Smith again mixing it up with punches and kicks. And Young responds in kind.
And Carrie Vera's a beast. And he did get in the victory.
Wow. Smith's combinations, you know, they're flying, but they're hitting. And she's backing Young up. She's doing a really good job controlling the action there.
Straight left from Young through the guard of Smith. Smith's good head movement, like you said, overhand right. Now into the clinch, Young. At close quarters.
Nice elbow on the exchange.
Nice knee on the exit from Smith.
Kaitlin looks to be bleeding a little bit from her nose, and looks like Smith's got a little mouse under her eye.
It's the vestiges of battle. It's been a very hard-hitting affair thus far.
I'm loving this fight.
Very good fight.
I want them to fight five rounds.
I like the jab that Young is throwing out there. Mm-hmm. Set the pace.
Good lateral movement there by Young. Good footwork. Just trying to stay away. Nicely done. Evading that right hand from Smith. Smith, though, backs her up against the peg. Oh, and gets her head popped back like a Pez dispenser. But I like how Smith sneaks in that low leg kick while delivering up top.
Yeah, you know, she's doing a great job of it. She's low, high, just like Kaitlin was doing in the first round.
But you see, I think that Smith is coming with that Margarito type pace. Even though Young is landing shots, I can see that Smith, you can see her Young slowing down a little bit.
I agree with you. I think that what you called earlier, when Young moves forward, she wins. Smith's the one doing the moving forward right now. Young's got really good lateral action and really good counter responses, but she needs to push forward. She has some hard knees. I'd like to see some of those midsection knees.
It looks like she's getting tired a little bit. Much better than a
counter right from Young. Lead left from the Minnesota Martial Arts Academy student again.
And those right hands are landing on Smith, though. She's doing that Terminator dance. Moving forward.
Oh, and again, Smith with the body. Beautiful right hand to the rib cage.
And that hurts.
Mm.
Well, it hurts me at least. Maybe not her.
High head kick blocked by Young. 2 minutes remaining in the middle stanza.
Oh, nice setup.
And great left. Nice. Oh. Nothing but action here between Leslie Smith and Kaitlin Young. Side leg kick from Smith. Left hand by Young.
You know,
there's the jab, double put up. And the left head kick.
Yeah, these are the fights where they stand toe-to-toe and they just deliver and deliver over and over again. These are the fights. You're on the edge of your seat.
Tremendous excitement here between Leslie Smith and Kaitlin Young. And Smith again mixing it up with kicks and a three-punch combination upstairs.
Yeah, Smith's really finding her range here. She's able to land multiple punches and multiple kicks now. But again, Kaitlin Young is, you know, her lateral motion is what's working very effectively for her. I wish she would capitalize on some of the angles she's getting.
Well, it's interesting that Smith works at Team Caesar Gracie, and her volume of punching and striking very similar to that of the Diaz brothers.
I'd like to see her go to the body a little more.
Yeah, she's very effective with the body work. And meanwhile, Kaitlin Young backing up, but also delivering her fair share. There's that overhand right.
Nice body kick.
Very effective with the kicks and the punches, but Young again stops her with that straight right hand. There's the left from Smith. Body kick from Young. 30 seconds left in another entertaining round. Outside leg kick to the lead leg administered by Young. Smith, Young intercepts her. It looked like Smith was going to deliver a left kick, and Young came upstairs with a punch. Final 10 seconds of the second stanza. Switch kick from Smith.
This is kind of a volume versus power.
Good point. Very well said. Franklin. If you think he reminds you of Rich Franklin, well, that's because it's his brother. Young in the black and white, Smith in the black and red.
Smith came running into the action there. She is ready to go right now.
These two athletes putting it all on the line here in the third and final round. A striker's gallery here. There's a firing off at every angle, using every weapon, punches and kicks.
Nice kick right there.
And a body kick from
that
Smith.
Hurt. Yeah.
Wants to tenderize that lead leg and then goes upstairs under the armpit. Right hand, and you're right, Kaitlin Young now trying to build off this momentum, but Leslie Smith, this is a firefight!
She switched to southpaw for a second, too. Oh, right
hand. Oh, overhand hit. Oh, wow.
Nice sprawl.
Young.
Nice sprawl. Nice
Young. Chain.
Getting those body shots against her, though, like that, like you guys said, that's going to hurt.
So Young looking for the takedown, but the good takedown defense here by Leslie Smith. Some punches to the body. Now it looks like there may be, blood. Kaitlin Young must be cut as blood is on the leg of Leslie Smith.
But she did a smart thing by switching out to a single leg.
Yeah, going out.
Oh, now a smart.
Oh, very well. Oh,
and Smith lands
Smith
on top.
Ends up in top position. Oh, Kaitlin trying for an armbar attempt there.
These two ladies are going at it like a dentist and a carpenter, tooth and nail, baby!
Now, this is great body work. Someone like, you know, Eddie Alvarez or people, you know, guys from Philly, they love body. They love to go in the body. And
speaking of the guys from Philly, I don't know if B-Hop and Dawson can provide us with action like this, Mo.
Kaitlin trying for an armbar. Young trying for an armbar right now. Locks her legs together, though. I feel like if she unlocked her legs and hiked them down, she'd be able to get a little more leverage or turn and go belly down. Oh, going for the triangle now.
Transitioning to the triangle.
Smith defending it.
And great job by Smith, who ends up in cross-side position.
Oh, my gosh, going for an armbar of her own. Good
Lord,
this is awesome.
Look at her putting that left leg over the face. That's awesome.
Wow. Give these ladies lots of money.
Whoa. Leslie Smith
incredible.
And Young escaping into open guard. The fans here in Kansas City on Fuego, the action hot and heavy.
Kaitlin Young looking to get her ground and pound established now. I know she wants a good top position.
What a fight.
Oh, looking for the knee on the way out. Nicely done.
Young with the cut over her left eye.
Smith doesn't care. She's going to keep coming forward.
Flashing the jab. Smith misses with the overhand right. Young stays in the pocket, flashes the left hand.
You people watching from home, women can fight.
That they can.
Hey, from now on, I'm going to start calling Leslie Smith Lil Diaz. Because Lil Diaz is fighting just like
Lil Diaz. Wow, nice right hand from Young.
Lead right from Young. Smith coming forward. Nice. 1-2 combination of her own. There's a body kick from Smith and a left hand upstairs. Inside leg kick from the bloodied Young.
Man, look at her leg. She has got a big welt on that leg. I would like to see Kaitlin working even more leg kicks this fight.
We were treated to a barn burner between Sarah Kaufman and Alexis Davis on the last Strike Force preliminary card. And Kaitlin Young and Leslie Smith looking to give them a run for their money here on the first Invicta Fighting Championships event. A minute and a half left in the fight.
Nice right hand.
Overhand right from Smith.
Kaitlin looking to time her shots a little bit here. I think she really wants to hit a really strong
shot. Oh, she almost ducked into an uppercut from Smith.
Nice.
Body kick from Young, both of them.
They're going to have some sore ribs in the morning.
Giving as good as they are getting. Punch kick combination from Young. Final 60 seconds of what has been a spirited affair between Kaitlin Young and Leslie Smith. What do they have left for us here in the final 53 seconds of this incredible fight?
This is amazing.
I'm speechless.
I know a lot of people watching wish I were. Smith.
Nice kick.
And another kick. Oh, and that hurts. That hurts Smith. She's limping now. Smith is in pain.
Young hits it again.
The determination.
It hurt her earlier this round, too.
And Young goes upstairs with the right hand. Final 22 seconds. Look at Smith still unloading a kick.
Now she's walking a little bit more tenderly, but she's not going to give up any ground there.
Both of these phenomenal athletes leaving every ounce of their fighting spirit inside the cage. The final 10 seconds of what has been a phenomenal fight.
The best fight I've seen in a long time.
Smith and Young are going at it till the final bell. Invicta FC 1 has arrived.
Great fight. Great
that
fight.
That was amazing.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, all you can ever ask of a professional athlete is that they leave it all on their chosen field of battle. And these two did that for you tonight at Invicta FC.
Bringing the crowd to their feet.
We turn it over to the judges. And here's what they tell us. Judge Kevin Champion scores the bout 29-28, blue corner. Judge Henry Geary scores the bout 29-28, red corner. And Judge Victoria Millipence scores the bout 29-29, a draw.
Whoa,
rematch.
Hey, Shannon and Janet, Invicta FC 2, I think we already have one fight. A rematch between Kaitlin Young and Leslie Smith is in order. And while they both are maybe shocked by the outcome, I think the fans are the biggest winners.
See this one again.
Yeah, no doubt.
I see this one again every day. I have to train.
No.
And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, in this much-anticipated rematch. This time, the score will be settled. Three rounds scheduled in the bantamweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner. Her style, Muay Thai and Jiu-Jitsu. At 5'9" tall, she weighed an officially 135.5 pounds. As a professional, her record stands 3 victories, 2 defeats, and 1 draw. Fighting out of Pleasant Hill, California, here is Leslie Smith! And next, her opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner. Her style, Muay Thai and wrestling. Also standing 5'9" tall, she weighed in 135 pounds. As a professional, 14 bouts under her belt, 7 wins, 6 defeats, and 1 draw. Fighting out of and representing St. Louis Park, Minnesota, here is Kaitlin Young! Referee in charge of the action, Rob Hines.
Rob Hines is the referee. Our friend at Fight Odds, Nick Kalikas, giving us the closing odds for this bout. Kaitlin Young at minus 175. Leslie Smith at plus 145. A split draw settled nothing at Invicta FC 1. The rematch is upon us.
I expect you to follow my instructions. Protect yourself at all times. Any questions? Any questions? All right, touch gloves, back off. We'll get it going.
Young began training in martial arts at the age of 14, earned a black belt in Taekwondo. Smith, very skilled in her striking and wanting to finish the job here tonight. Young versus Smith 2 begins now. And immediately they come together in the clinch. Dirty boxing, knee strike by Smith, a knee from Young. And they quickly exchange strikes at close quarters up along the cage. Another knee to the midsection by Young. No feeling out process in this one is we've got Smith. They're back against the fence trying to pummel Young with a knee strike. They separate to the center of the cage. Nice body kick by Young. Jab from Smith.
They're just right in each other's faces. Right to start.
Great exchange here to kick things off. And these two in their fourth round are beginning right where they left off in round three back in Invicta FC 1.
Now Leslie has her against the cage. Oh, a reversal from Young.
Nice elbow.
Another elbow on the exit by Young, the right hand, a left body kick by Smith, and a jab. This is with the right cross, inside leg kick. Smith unloading now up top. Tie plumb by Young, the knee. Collar tie by Smith. Truculent affair, captures a kick and drops Young. But Young looking for the submission.
Nice.
An omoplata attempt, maybe. Going for the arm now, the shoulder lock. .245 left in the first round.
Both kind of tied up together there with Leslie in top position, but her arm is still hooked. Kaitlin doesn't have the arm bar anymore, so Leslie's corner is calling for her to sit down, establish a good top guard. Knee to the shoulder from top.
This is a crazy position right here.
Yeah.
Whoever's head's higher could win, but if Leslie sits back, she could win this scramble.
Yeah.
And she's doing that, grabbing the leg, sitting back.
Leslie's she's got her pinned in a really good position there.
Leslie bends into side control. Dropping the hammer fist to the body, and again, Young goes for the arm.
Oh.
Oh, reverse triangle.
And she's the arm in there, but she's stuck there, but
hard to finish, but it does slow down her attacks.
There's no attack, really.
Well, coming up next, Sarah DeLelio against Shayna Baszler. DeLelio picked up the reverse triangle armbar win in her last fight against Vanessa Porto. Porto returning to defeat MMA pioneer Tara La Rosa tonight. Oh, hammer fist from Smith now on her feet. Young against the fence, kick to the back of her leg. Another kick to the gluteus maximus area. Up kick by Young, but Smith comes into the close guard, working the body. Minute left in the first round. Body shots from Smith, ground and pound.
Caitlin's trying to acquire an angle on the ground and attack the arms again, and she's got her 90-degree angle there, but she's got to get over the head, or under the head, excuse me. Oh, and Smith just postures right out of it.
And Caitlin's doing a good job of pulling the head down and keeping her from landing anything effective.
Elbow from Smith. Nice.
Besides the elbow.
Good pass there.
Less than 30 seconds left in the round. Smith from top position has formed Matwell. open half guard. Is that the full? No, open half guard. And ground and pound from Smith, though, right hands as Young still fishing for that arm. 15 seconds left in the frame. Oh, again, ground and pound from Smith, and really putting it on Young here. Young giving up her back. Flurry of right hands from Smith, looking for the choke, and the bell goes. Leslie Smith, the bell, and round two. Inside leg kick by Smith, quickly goes upstairs with a strike, feints the knee, kick.
Kaitlin attempts her own takedown.
Young in the black and white, Smith in the white and black. Smith muscles Young to the cage, knee. There's a slashing elbow across Young's face. Another elbow strike, right hand. Very busy is Leslie Smith, mixing up her striking early in round two.
This is some good pummeling and some good jockeying position, mixed with knees and strikes and elbows.
Young looking for the takedown, shoots for the double. Defended by Smith, looking to shuck her off.
Rolling knee bar attempt. Wow.
Smith looking for the knee bar. Young defending well, though, back into top position, but Smith very tenacious.
Another roll from the corner.
Smith training with the Diaz brothers, Caesar Gracie, and the rest of the crew at Pleasant Hill, California, showcasing some of her ground game here. Young defending.
Great scramble right there.
Put herself into a guillotine position there, but they're a...
Scramble here between Young
Crazy scramble.
And Smith. Wow. Smith ends up in top position. A minute and a half gone in the second stanza. Working the body and then going upstairs to the head with her right hand. But Young, active guard.
One thing I've noticed about this fight, you know, Smith looks a lot stronger and a lot more powerful than the last time they fought.
Absolutely. She told me she's putting a lot more emphasis on her strength and conditioning.
Now, past the guard again, ground and pound from side control. Ooh. Has the mounted crucifix, and she is unloading on Kaitlin Young. Leslie Smith from the crucifix, right hands. Steady diet of right hands to Kaitlin Young, who's desperately flailing, trying to escape, but she is pinned. Leslie Smith going to town on Kaitlin Young. And it's over. Smith vanquishes Young via second round TKO. Ground and pound from the mounted crucifix. She picks up the win.
Ladies and gentlemen, the end comes in 2 minutes, 19 seconds. Round number two, stoppage due to strikes for your winner by TKO victory, Leslie Smith. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner. She has a background in jiu-jitsu and Muay Thai. At 5'7" tall, she weighed in officially 134¾ pounds. As a professional, her record stands 3 wins and 2 losses. She fights out of Colorado Springs, Colorado. Here is Raquel! Her opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner. A mixed martial artist standing 5'9" tall. She weighed in 135¾ pounds and brings a professional record of 4 wins, 2 defeats, 1 draw. Fighting out of Pleasant Hill, California, she is Leslie, the Peacemaker Smith! Referee in charge, Chuck Wolf.
The audience is too funny.
Boo! Yeah! It's like a movie setting, you know what I'm saying? The Rocky chanting, the reggae music, all that.
Oh,
a lot of intensity in that stare.
Oh, yeah.
She's got LBR, lumbar scrutiny on her.
With the double underhooks there.
really high.
Nope, over and under, actually.
Like this.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We'll take a double on the hook.
I go, it's going to be hard to throw even from that point. Catch, keep it on the ground, though. Got to pull that leg out. Oh, gonna go for knee
bar. Yep.
Yeah.
She's so active. You know, she's always, always looking for something.
Look at Smith climbing her legs up over the top there to create space to come out the back door.
And use that momentum. Did you see that? How she did that? That was beautiful. Shifted her weight.
Rocky transitions to the back, but yeah, she's leaving that knee in there. It's dangerous. Very dangerous.
But she's got to bend the leg for that. But that's going to be hard for Rocky to hit.
Yeah, Rocky's using that, you know, to take top position. She does have to really concentrate on getting that leg in the right position while she's doing these shots, because, you know, any transition could leave her in more trouble.
Oh, when she stretched her leg, that's the moment she can put it on. They left Mari Schmidt upside down.
Now it's okay.
Now she's free. There you go.
Just kick the knees.
Rocky's corner is actually asking to let her back up. Rocky disregarded that. She wants her top position again.
But heading on.
Side choke, yep. But she turns away from it.
You have it.
Yeah, why she trained over there? With the braces, that should be okay. But is she underneath? Whoa, wait a minute. Wow. She's underneath? I can't tell either.
It's blocked out. She is attempting to get her hooks in and stretch her out. That's, you know, the thing you can do from back position is it, if even if you don't have the choke, stretch them, lengthen their body out.
Looks like she's under the arm. Looks like she's under the arm. I can't tell from this angle. Yeah, she's under her arm, under the arm. She's
stalling. Yeah. Nice.
Wow.
Nice scramble. Whoa, nice.
Yeah, we got to pull it up a little bit.
Arm and guillotine to create space for knees.
Good knees.
Wow. And disengaging on an uppercut. Hard front kick. Those side kicks, she's turning her back a little bit on those, so she's got to be careful on that because Leslie can hop right in after that.
Now, it looks like Leslie's trying to put the pace on her now.
Yep. Rocky again attempting a double leg, comes up to high hooks, but her head's in pretty deep. If it does go to the ground, she's got to make sure she clears the legs and doesn't get stuck in a guillotine.
She has that body locked up, but maybe she needs to fight inside, get her, move her left arm.
Ooh, foot stomps. And back and forth.
She needs to pull her left arm out. It's in too deep. Heads out. Good knees.
Leslie puts her on the cage now.
This is a fast-paced fight right here. With Rocky being from Colorado Springs, I'm pretty sure she has nothing to worry about as far as conditioning.
Yeah, high-altitude training is very helpful. But, you know, on the other hand, Leslie is a training machine. Like, we saw her war with Kaitlin Young, the first war with it, and she didn't guess. And, I mean, those two were just going to town. I like the way that Rocky's using his head position to, I don't know, just get her, like, scrappy inside shots on her. You know what I mean? Like, Leslie's got length, so when she pushes her head down, she's able to launch her attacks.
Got to watch out for closing the distance to her. Oh, something's showing. They got to. Yeah, I think the referee should momentarily stop for a second because once she turns into us, I think something's showing.
For those of you at home, you know, this is a professional event, and attire is it's an important thing to take into consideration. 10 seconds left in this round. I think there'll be enough time to make the suitable adjustments.
I think that's going to be okay, yeah.
Leslie's getting a lot more aggressive with those hands there, you know. Rocky's corner was yelling, "Let your hands go, Rocky," and as they were returning. And I think they know.
She throws only power shots. Rocky should throw two shots, three shots. Everything is one single shot. See? Dang, dang, everything. It's never pam, pam. She needs to open up something with the shot, and then the second or the third one hopefully connects.
Now in this clinch position, she was very successful in the first round, but I guess she wants to disengage and throw more strikes here.
I like what Raquel's doing, throwing leg kicks and throwing kicks, because Kaitlin Young was pretty successful in the first fight.
Yeah.
She throws combinations.
Yeah, that straight jab overhand is actually landing very well for Smith.
It's because it's a combination.
Rocky needs to go back to throwing the inside leg kick, because that's one thing that was really landing and working for real well.
It was. Inside leg kick to a right hand is going to land there. Nice fakes by Smith.
I feel like she's getting overwhelmed now. Smith is trying to overwhelm her, trying to take over this fight now.
She just throws by. Everything's a single shot.
Now, I know these two used to train together. They worked very closely together, and I'm wondering how familiar they are with each other's style, or if they've noticed evolutions in each other. Or if they're not thinking and they just want to hit.
I feel like Leslie kind of wasn't surprised, because now you see her, she's coming. She's still doing the same thing she did last round. Nothing's changed. She's still going forward, throwing more punches, though. I think she expected the wrestling first round.
Yeah, Rocky is counting on a single shot, and she hopes one's going to hit it out of the ballpark, and she shouldn't do that. Throw two power shots. It doesn't matter if you connect them. Right after the inside low kick as well.
That's not the range.
Who's going to win like this?
She does a good job with those knees, though, grabbing onto the head. Oh, nice jump right in.
Nice body hat. Spleen right hook. One of my favorite combinations, actually.
I think that Rocky at this point needs to clinch up and take it down to the ground again.
She needs to get her back off the cage and try keeping the center somehow.
Yeah, Leslie's doing a great job of keeping her at range with those long arms.
Yeah, look at that.
Rattling off those punches.
Combinations. That's the whole key to victory here.
She's slowly starting to overwhelm her.
I like the way Leslie will hold on her and then hit the body, hit the head, hit the body, hit the head. Nice.
She's a nice hockey fight.
Relentless.
Boom, nice look at that knee.
Beautiful. Rocky, she's grabbing the head and throwing those inside, those uppercuts. But I don't know, I just think Leslie's overwhelming her a little bit.
And I like the way Leslie's throwing that jab. Oh, nice body kick, right hand. Oh,
look at this. And the uppercut hook.
Hook, right hand. It's there.
Right, it's right there.
But the thing is, I think she's too tired, because she's getting hit clean, and she's.
Yeah, but she's not doing from the first second.
She's fighting the pace. She's fighting the pace of Leslie Smith. Leslie Smith's good pressure.
Oh, there's a side kick.
For every one punch, for every four punches Leslie throws, Rocky throws one.
Leslie is known for her volume punching as well. It's Rocky's had success with power shots in previous fights.
That was a hard knee. She felt that one. Now a front kick there.
A little damage on the cheekbone of Leslie Smith right now.
Nice body.
That's very nice here from Pennington.
She's not getting off the cage. Leslie's like, come on. All right, get off the cage. Let's strike. Taunting a little bit there, Diaz style. Oh, Rocky Psyche got her to the ground, though. Here we go, back to those scrambles.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, if you hear me say single shots and you don't want close combinations, you know right away who it is, right?
Oh, Leslie comes right out of the back. Smith.
Distraction. I never, ever heard anybody break a foot because of that.
No, it's just...
But it's really good for distraction, yeah. For balancing, putting the foot away.
Yeah, absolutely. It makes you want to defend that foot, and then the other one is giving up.
These girls are really fighting right here. Or should I say these ladies, or these women.
These fighters.
These vicious fighters. Ladies.
Because they're just going, they're going
yeah.
at it.
I have yet to be disappointed by a Leslie Smith fight in Invicta, I'll say that. And Rocky just going toe-to-toe with her right now. We know that Rocky now wants to be clinched. She wants to be on the inside. And Smith definitely wants to have her on the end, have her on the end of those punches. But when you back up to the cage like that.
Move away. Up again. Like,
yeah.
Oh, right, right, right. But that's good. For her, for the next time, when she sees this, she's going to know. Right up a good left hook. Left hook, right up a good.
I don't think she's grabbing the cage. Maybe she did, but.
Right up a good from left elbow. That's a good. Nobody does that. Left hook, right elbow.
They're in the range for that, for sure. Look at how she's reaching over the head, trying to secure an arm and guillotine. I don't know that.
It's not going to happen like
yeah,
that.
I don't think that this is going to happen because of the leverage that Smith has with her underhook. In fact, it could just put Rocky in a bad position on her back.
Smith should go for a knee tap and with the passer on her right side.
Smith should make sure that the body's now on the other side.
All right, now Rocky.
Just walk to the other side. Opposite side right ahead is good. She can lift her. Just squat, put one arm in between the legs and lift.
I feel as though Rocky should have used that position like she did in the earlier round to pull the head down and just launch those knees to the body.
Yeah, you don't need to. Wasting energy for nothing.
Oh, now Rocky's in the guillotine.
And that could be. And because it looks deeper to me.
It does. I think Rocky's got her hands in a position to move to a high crotch.
Yeah, she has high crotch position.
She might even jump and catch that arm also. Oh, no, she doesn't. It wasn't locked. She cannot afford a takedown, though. She needs to keep standing now.
Man, I almost wish she would use that left leg, just bring it up and kick.
Everyone wants
Pennington
to see a suplex.
Needs to take this fight to the ground because then if she gets on top, she might pull it off a victory. Come on, take your shot, boom, boom. I love the way Leslie Smith keeps pushing forward with us. Muck, muck, muck.
You know, I think
like,
that
no care.
Smith Delalio might be interesting.
You know, Leslie Smith, she pushes forward. You have to fight, you fight her, you fight her pace.
A little taunting and cage taunting going on there. Nice kick.
Great showmanship.
Yeah. Yeah.
Trading low kicks here. They're going to feel it tomorrow.
If I were Raquel Pennington, I would go for a takedown.
I would too. I would grab that leg and take it down, but I think Smith might be in her head.
Almost the last minute. That would kill the combination.
Beautiful.
And right away it connects.
That double jab cross should have been there. Like, oh, no lead with the kick. Smith again is rocking with those.
I really don't. This round is pretty close.
Well, I think that, you know, when you're watching this from home, that showmanship, it's just like, hey, come on, come over here. That definitely, nice, straight right. That definitely plays into the viewers at home and makes them think, oh, okay, well, she's owning this. And, you know, I think she's definitely had more volume in this round.
Yeah. But you know, Leslie Smith pressed the action. Oh,
yeah.
I think it's shot.
It's hard to win. It's hard to win a fight when everybody's seen your back against the cage the whole round. And I think that Pennington's actually throwing some really hard, solid shots. I just don't know that it's gonna.
She just didn't time to get
it. Nice flurry. Just walking straight at her like crazy.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the scorecards. All three judges have it, 29-28.
Yeah.
Your winner by unanimous decision, the Peacemaker, Leslie Smith!
I'm going to go out there and say this. Leslie Smith is one of the most entertaining fighters on my list. I have quite a few, you know.
I co-sign that.
Her, Jessamyn Duke, Kaitlin Young, Delelio is very entertaining to me.
Here once again, Joe Martinez.
And now, fight fans, here we go. Three rounds. This is in the bantamweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist standing 5 feet, 9 inches tall, weighing in officially 135 pounds. Her professional record stands 5 victories, 2 defeats, and 1 draw. Fighting out of Pleasant Hill, California, here is Leslie, the Peacemaker Smith. And next, her opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner. Her background is boxing and jiu-jitsu. At 5 feet, 5 inches tall, she weighed in 135 and one half pounds. A 17-fight veteran, she brings 15 victories in just 2 defeats. Fighting out of and representing Victoria, British Columbia, Canada, here is Sarah Kaufman. Referee in charge, Drake Franklin.
In honor of the estimable Boss Roon, who filled in for me at Invicta FC 4, and he was crazy that night.
Yeah.
I just want to say, my Canadians will understand what that means. Sarah Kaufman, Leslie Smith, let's go. By the way, Boss Roon and Stephen Quadros will be handling Glory World Series action from Turkey tomorrow at gloryworldseries.com. Rematch between Daniel Gita and Gokhan Saki, and this one could be just as good as Saki versus Gita, as we've got Smith versus Kaufman.
Oh, nice. Sarah's already hit her, I think, with 3 punches, and that was a nice jab there on that exchange. Look at the way Sarah uses head movement when she throws her punches. It's really nice. It's very hard to punch her when she's punching you. I know this because she punches me a lot. I think Leslie's going to try and use her reach. And, you know, if I were Leslie, I'd be using kicks, like front kicks and head kicks to kind of keep her at bay.
Kaufman is, without a doubt, one of the most technical strikers in women's MMA. Very talented, former dancer, was on her way to medical school before she discovered mixed martial arts and has been a champion in various organizations, including Strikeforce, and now, before making her UFC debut, she makes her Invicta FC debut, but against a very tough customer in Leslie the Peacemaker Smith.
And you see, right now, it seems like Leslie's
uppercuts by Smith. Go
she's
ahead.
Kind of loading up on some of her punches. She's a
wow, it's almost fried Takayama, the female guy momentarily. Or the beginning of it, at least. Relax, people. Don't say, you know, Moroan is hyperbole again.
Like your hyperbole.
Well, hyperbole is the greatest word ever. And now it's Kaufman pinning Smith along the cage momentarily. Smith circles away. Now has Kaufman knee right up the middle by Smith.
She landed a series of knees before this break right here. But I think this is the pace that Leslie should fight for the first period to try to negate some of Sarah Kaufman's movement.
Well, we anticipated a smorgasbord of strikes, and that's what we're getting here in the opening round. 10 of Kaufman's 15 wins have come by way of knockout. 3 of Smith's 5 victories have come via form of KO, and they are throwing lots of leather here early.
It's very hard to time Sarah's punches because she'll often end on a jab while she's moving to the side. You know, and again, her head moves with her body. It's very hard to time that. Let's see if Leslie can get a gauge on that. Leslie was hitting some nice body shots and some nice uppercuts. Beautiful kick.
Kick.
Right to the
finding
face.
The target by Smith. What did you get a chance to spar with Sarah?
No, I haven't.
Because you've been injured.
Yeah,
right?
I haven't been able to train in like 6 months.
So have you been able to watch her? Did she come to New Mexico or was she stayed in Victoria?
She came slightly. She did a lot of.
I was just going to ask you, what was the one thing that... Oh, Holly Holm, a former boxer, turned mixed martial artist, great fighter. But I was wondering what impressed you the most in this camp if you did see her. And there, wow, impressive striking from both of them here. And they're just loading up. There's a right hand over the top by Smith. Going downstairs to the body with a right. Now the tie plumb by Smith and delivers a knee along the fence. Kaufman with a knee of her own.
I wouldn't mind seeing a... Leslie tried to go
for a takedown. Oh, nice elbow by Kaufman on the exit.
Let's see Leslie go for a takedown of some sort.
I think so, too. I think with a precise striker like Sarah Kaufman, you almost have to make it ugly. You have to make it a scrap. And Leslie's very good at, not that she fights ugly, I shouldn't say that, but she's very good at scrapping and pulling people into her game.
Three-punch combination by Kaufman. There's the kick by Smith, but Kaufman counters with a nice punch. So great action here, as we anticipated. We thought it would be a bantamweight barn burner, and we are seeing the beginning of just that between Kaufman and Smith. Push kick by Smith, keeping her at bay. Kaufman sticks the jab, follows up with the right cross.
And the funny thing is, with Kaufman fighting Smith, you rarely see another fighter with a volume like Leslie Smith, but we're seeing it today right now. And Sarah Kaufman, who's probably throwing more.
Yeah, I think Sarah's very good at volume punches, which is what Smith has relied on a lot. I think, again, the key to Smith's victory is going to be those. She does a good job with those knees, bringing them up the middle, but I think it's head kicks. Head kicks and leg kicks are what's going to get her through in here. It's a nice elbow from Smith there, but she's, you know, again, she's kind of, Sarah's dictating who ends the exchange.
Oh, left head kick by Smith. For those of you wondering on Twitter, is my musical ode to Bob and Doug McKenzie, a couple of Canadian hosers from SCTV fame. Thank you. And look at this. Canadian Kaufman, American Smith. They are lighting each other up here with 10 seconds left in the round. And without a doubt, the best action we have seen thus far here at Invicta FC 5. Kaufman and Smith going to round number two. Both prepared. Second round is underway. Let's hope the second verse is the same as the first, Mo.
I think it's going to be better.
Left hook there. Lead left hook by Smith. Catches Kaufman. Smith mixing in the kicks. Kaufman comes back with a 1-2 combination. Inside leg kick low by Smith. Ooh, nice jab stuck by Kaufman. Kaufman, ooh, instead of the 1-2 combination, there was a jab and an elbow strike mixing it up.
Yeah, I know, and look at those angles that Smith is coming at. Those are the angles that are going to be able to hit. You know, Sarah's defense is very high. She keeps her hands in the right position. Well, but when Smith comes at these strange angles, that's what's going
to
hit.
I know the fans won the first round, and I know it's very tough to call, but anybody willing to go out on a limb here, Mo?
You go first.
Who won that first round?
I have it, Kaufman, but I could be biased.
Oh, what action in the second round?
I do have it, Kaufman, for volume, but I think that Smith is she's definitely holding her own in this, ooh, and I could see it both ways.
Elbow from Kaufman, uppercut from Smith. Now they're both looking for the tie plumb. Smith has it, but Kaufman pushing her against the fence. Blocking. Oh, nice slashing elbow by Smith. There's a right hand to the side of the head by Kaufman. It is continuous action, even at close quarters. This is dirty boxing, Mo.
Yep, and this body work that that Leslie's doing with the knees is really going to, you know, you'll see it pay off later this round.
Kaufman again, keeping it simple but effective with a 1-2 combination, three-punch combination over the top with the right hand. Smith now with the jab. Good footwork by Kaufman. Smith coming right forward, and again, they just continue to go. Mano a mano, mamma mia! Left head kick knockout! Possible here, the left head kick, not the knockout. I apologize, but what a shot by Smith.
Beautifully done by Smith. Just took advantage of that positioning to... Wow, that was
taking
really
a page
nice.
Out of the
right
playbook, and I apologize to Sarah Kaufman. Lots of fight still left in the resilient Canadian, no doubt about that. What a fight we're seeing.
We'll see how she fares off her back here. You know, Sarah's got a very strong top game, but off her back, you know, it's hard to get her there. Like, only two people have done it, and that's Coenen and, that actually one person's done it, and that's Rousey.
Well, Kaufman doing a good job of keeping Smith at bay after that.
Nice up kick.
Left head kick. Nice up kick to the torso by Kaufman. Diving in is Smith, and Kaufman very busy off her back delivering those right hands.
And I talked to Leslie Smith, after the last Invicta. She said that she'd love to fight Sarah Kaufman, and she'd come in here to defend her house in this Invicta.
I think I'm going to lose my Canadian citizenship with my premature call there, and I apologize again profusely, just getting caught up in the action here. It's been a few months since I've called MMA. Give me a break. Smith.
I think you're just fine.
Right.
Yes.
Oh, looking to pass the guard, dropping the right hand, but Kaufman doing a really good job off her back.
Great job, but at the same time, you know, who would you rather be? Would you rather be Kaufman?
Right now, it's Leslie Smith with the momentum, it seems, but after knocking Kaufman down, was unable to really capitalize. And like I say, Kaufman doing a good job of keeping Smith at bay here.
You know, but, you know, you see Smith standing over the top of her. You know, she is in a position where she can cause the most damage. You know, I think at this point, Kaufman should be looking to get back to her feet. I know that's dangerous to do right now when, you know, you're in a position to be hit so much. Oh, back up. It's like,
wow, Kaufman is back to her feet. The fans applaud this terrific tilt between Kaufman and Smith. So Kaufman survives the turbulent waters, and now again they continue. Kaufman unloading the right hand.
And you know, those are the exchanges that when she fought that amazing fight with Alexis Davis in 2012, you know, just standing right in the pocket.
You know what, and I will say this right now, with you here at cage side, your fight with Misha Tate, her fight with Alexis Davis, I mean, two of the most memorable battles that I've ever called and seen in women's MMA, and we're seeing another one here tonight.
Absolutely. Now look, Sarah's back to her kind of pinpoint precision striking.
Oh man, they both could take a shot.
Yeah, and Leslie's back to like, okay, I'm gonna find the opening, I'm gonna find the angle here. Really smart fighting
by
both of them.
Wow, look at Smith now with the right hand, the kick.
Oh, another kick.
Unbelievable action here in Kansas City.
These girls are scrapping. These girls are scrapping, boy.
Yeah.
Woo. Locked that left kick. Right kick by Smith. It has been all action from the opening bell. 20 seconds now left in the second stanza. Back at close quarters, knee stuck by Smith. Kaufman now puts her on the cage, creates some distance, maybe looking to deliver a knee of her own. Less than 10 seconds left in what has been a scintillating second stanza between Smith and Kaufman at Invicta FC 5. Bring it on!
Oh, wow.
And both women are barely even breathing.
They're sprinting out there to the middle of the cage.
Smith in the black and red, Kaufman in the purple and black. Something tells me they're going to be black and blue after this one is over, but a fantastic fight thus far. Overhand right by Kaufman, catches the kick. Smith turns around, and Kaufman now bull rushes her to the cage.
And I think that's a smart strategy for Kaufman to try and take her down and, you know, oh, well, maybe not. Kaufman's going to Kaufman. You know, I to take her down and establish some ground and pound of her own in this round. Maybe tire Leslie out off her back, although it looks like it's pretty hard to tire Leslie out.
Yeah. Really, Sarah Kaufman's the right thing by the level changes, the feints, using angles and throwing her jab and throwing her straight cross.
And with those kicks and those long punches of Leslie, you know, you either have to be all the way in, I think, or all the way out. You can't be in that middle range with her.
Push kick by Kaufman, counter right by Smith, who delivers a left body kick as well. The action fast and furious between Invicta FC newcomer, former Strikeforce Women's Bantamweight Champion Sarah Kaufman and one of Invicta FC's brightest stars, Leslie Smith.
I like the way how Kaufman will lead with a jab cross and sometimes she'll lead with a cross jab. You know, it's a very good way to confuse your opponent and kind of keep them wary of you.
And that jab,
blood beginning
cross jab.
Go ahead. Blood beginning to trickle from the nose of Sarah Kaufman. Push kick from Smith. 90 seconds gone in the final round. Collar tie, and again at close quarters, they just unleash. Jab by Smith. Kaufman with the right hand. I cannot believe the pace that they have maintained from the opening bell, Julie.
I can. These guys are amazing.
Oh, wow!
Double leg from Kaufman. Rarely
the element of surprise. The takedown by Kaufman here in round.
Oh, she's got to be careful, though. Leslie's got a very, very good jiu-jitsu game, as we've seen in some of her previous fights. You know, she likes to move around on the ground. She likes to go for submissions.
Now
Leslie likes to finish fights.
Can't
take that kick nowhere.
10 of Sarah Kaufman's 15 victories are inside the distance, so Smith now. Kaufman back on their feet. 2 minutes and 30 seconds left in this tantalizing tilt between Smith and Kaufman. The striking has been phenomenal.
I think Gita and Saki have a tough act to follow tomorrow,
Mo.
Another head kick from Smith.
Wow, head kick by Smith.
You know, she's seeing that opening there to kind of, with her long legs, wrap him almost around the neck. A nice right
nice
hand from
right
Sarah
hand
Popped
from
her head
Kaufman,
back.
Popping the head back of Smith, who still wants to try to kick her way inside. Under 2 minutes remaining in the bout.
But I like what Smith is doing, even though she's kicking her shield, kicking Sarah Kaufman's right arm. After Bikesby kicks that one right arm, sometimes it's just useless to throw.
Yeah, you can hold it lower and you won't generate as much power. That's
fight of the night performances are becoming de rigueur for Leslie Smith. She and Kaitlin Young lit it up at Invicta FC 1, winning Fight of the Night honors, and her and Sarah Kaufman are well on their way to doing the same here tonight at Invicta FC 5 with 90 seconds left in the bout.
Sometimes I forget to talk. I just want to say.
Well, I think, you know what, and I think the fans at home don't mind it. I'm as I gripped as you are. We can just let this action speak for itself. It's amazing.
Oh, another nice head kick from Smith.
That one did not knock Kaufman down, as it did earlier. A minute left in this terrific battle between Sarah Kaufman and Leslie Smith, and they continue to deliver the
double leg attempt by Sarah.
The double
see if she
leg.
Can finish this one.
Good defense by Smith.
Oh, wow. Yeah,
great
Smith
defense.
Does a great job defending it. Sarah's hand is on the ground to prevent those knees right there, and Leslie just yanks her head right back up.
I'm on the edge of my seat right now.
I know. Nice cage work from Leslie, moving her way off of there.
And good work by Kaufman,
yeah,
circling away from the cage. 30 seconds left in this firefight. Fistic fireworks on display between Kaufman and Smith.
Wow. I'm so excited by this fight. Oh,
Smith
another nice right hand.
Catches that right hand from Kaufman. Another overhand right by Kaufman. 15 seconds left, and they are going to continue to throw leather until the final bell. 10 seconds remaining between Kaufman and Smith. The fans here in Kansas City electrified. Can we please have a round four?
Oh,
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10.
Championships is all about.
One more time, Kansas City, show your love for these two female warriors. Here are the judges' scoring totals. Judge Russ Swanberg has it 29-28 for Kaufman. Judge Brett Miller, 29-28 Smith. And Judge Henry Gary, 29-28. Your winner by split decision, Sarah Kaufman! And off my fans, we are set to go. This bout scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds in the flyweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner. Her background is in jiu-jitsu and Muay Thai. Standing 5'4" tall, she weighed officially 124.5 pounds. Her professional record in 10 bouts, 7 victories, 2 defeats, and 1 draw. Hailing from Curitiba, Brazil, here is Jennifer Maia! And next, her opponent across the cage, fighting out of the red corner. Tonight, making her flyweight debut, her background is in Muay Thai and Jiu-Jitsu as well. At 5'9" tall, she weighed in 125 pounds and brings a professional record that stands 5 victories, 3 defeats, and 1 draw. She is the fighting pride of Pleasant Hill, California. Please welcome Leslie, the Peacemaker Smith. Referee in charge of the action, Big John McCarthy.
Big John McCarthy will preside over the proceedings for this flyweight contest. Maia representing Chuta Box in Curitiba, Brazil. Of course, a legendary camp under Hujamar Fedrigo. So many amazing fighters coming out of there. Vanderlei Silva, even Anderson Silva, the Hua brothers. Of course, Rafael Cordero, the big coach, who's now in charge of Kings MMA in the Golden State of California. The bell, and we are underway for this flyweight matchup.
It's going to be interesting to see how Jennifer Maia deals with Leslie Smith's volume, because she throws a lot of punches.
Punches and bunches, to coin a phrase.
Yeah.
Yeah, she likes to stand right in her own range and just really rattle off combinations.
Punches and mega dozens.
I think it's almost impossible for Leslie Smith to be in a boring fight.
Only she shot up boxing.
Body kick from her.
Yeah, even that's exciting. There's a nice right hand by Maia. High kick by Smith comes in. Maia clinches with a body lock against the cage. Looks for the takedown.
In the corners, yell for underhook, and that's the correct thing for you to do. Right side, get the underhook, and then look to get the left side underhook in too. Great distance, yes.
Oh, uppercut.
Nice left hook, right uppercut combination by Maia on the exit.
Oh, front kick to the face.
Front kick to the face. All right, Anderson Silva. There's that 1-2 combination. Now a slugfest beginning to develop. The high kick blocked by Maia. Backs up, resets. The kick is caught in the takedown by Smith. Slashing elbow across the face. Maia fishing for the armbar on the bottom.
Nice defense and composure by Smith. In a top position like that, that's scary to be on your guard as somebody throwing elbows.
Maia goes to push her off and get back to her feet. Put pressure on Smith.
Well, look at Smith attempting an armbar. Nice way to step over the top and use the cage. Use her environment for her attempt.
That's some great yoga flexibility.
Yeah, and good creativity too. Oh.
This fight is crazy.
Good start. Yeah. Just past the midway point of the opening round.
Maya's got her kind of smushed up there. Smith's attempting to cross-face her and create space.
Maya hooks the left leg. They look for the trip takedown. Smith comes out firing away from the cage. Push kick by Maia. Two minutes left in the round.
Because now, you know, the last fight, Maia pressed the action, mm-hmm. She pressed the pace. Now, she's fighting another woman that is taking the initiative and coming forward.
Nice combination executed by Maia. Good head movement. Smith backing up. Overhand right. Smith with the head kick, but that was blocked. Knee up the middle by Maia. Nice jab by Smith. Man, they're just swinging.
It's like two Tasmanian devils.
Ask Beck Hyatt about Tasmanian devils. She's from that area of Australia. Body punch by Smith and comes up over top with a right hand. There's the knee from Maia. Ooh, Smith just missed with that right hand, but sticks the jab.
It's a good fight.
Minute remaining in the first round.
Good jab.
I'd like to see Smith throw a jab and then an uppercut with the same hand.
Smith coming forward with strikes. Now the headlock by Maia. Trying to grind Smith. A nice right hand on the exit by Maia. High front kick. Well, there's a kick from Smith. Go ahead, Mo.
Smith reminds me of Antonio Margarito. She just slams you.
Yeah.
Except her wraps aren't taken. We know that Stitch Durant is doing it. Best for the biz. Look at the slap materializing. 15 seconds left in the round. A great start here between Jennifer Maia and Leslie
kick.
Smith. They're just throwing
Kaufman with the elbow to a roundhouse kick.
Nice body kick. That was a long 5 minutes.
Wow.
Maybe for the simple fact that Sharknado has already jumped the Sharknado. There you go. Thank you and good night. Smith and Maia, second round action. And look at this, right from the opening bell of the round, they are just going at it toe-to-toe. Body shots by Smith. Maia looks for the headlock. Smith almost pulling guard there, but...
Oh, rolling for a knee bar.
Gira, Now, dueling your hooks momentarily, except Maia now goes for Smith's back. Smith back up to her feet, and beautiful job here, scrambling into top position.
A little crazy scramble.
Yeah.
Open our legs first! Get off our legs first! Get off our legs first! I need our legs through! Perfect!
Maya's walking like if she's underhook. Not a great thing to do with the ground and pound right there. I would want to establish my platform first.
Yeah, whether it's in the stand-up or on the ground, it's a brawl with these two young ladies as Maia now trying to reverse Smith, but Smith putting all kinds of pressure on her from the half-open half-guard position. Wants to neutralize her right arm. Now Smith on her feet, behind the butt scoop position. Smith attacking her legs. And misses with that one, allows Maia to get back to her feet. But Smith comes in with a body kick and a counter left from Maia.
She just comes right back in.
Perpetual motion. Good counter combination by Maia.
I like the fact that Maya's coming with straight punches now. Because she's not going to be able to throw hooks and be effective with Smith. She's going to have to throw straight punches.
Yes. Head kick by Smith. And again, they are just throwing everything at each other. Thankfully, the kitchen sink is nailed down in this casino. Body kick from Smith. Maia with the punching combination. Ooh, gets stuck with the jab.
You can see some swelling on the forehead of Maia from, I think it's a lot of those right elbows that Leslie's been throwing.
You know, Mo, you've made a lot of boxing references. These two ladies are giving Leo Santa Cruz a run for his money. Yeah. Punching. Big shot.
Nice jab.
Great jab by
right
Smith.
Yep,
continues to stick that. But Maya's right there, staying in it and just coming forward. Clinching again with 2 minutes now left in the second round.
These are two well-conditioned athletes right here. This is a frantic pace.
Absolutely.
Obviously, the weight cut didn't affect Smith.
Not at all.
Seems to make him strong, make her stronger. Excuse me.
Front kick again, just misses by Maia. There's a kick off the shoulder.
I like the way she throws it without premeditation. It just, those kicks come out of nowhere. It's really, really good fighting.
And Maya's maintaining the pace as well, keeps coming forward. Counter strikes by Smith. Left hook by Smith. And a left hand kick that jacked the jaw. Maia, she recovers with the trip takedown. Into guard, half butterfly guard. Now the open guard.
Straight to the triangle. Leslie, who's the wall to push? Who's the wall to push?
Grab it with your toes.
She's locked in the arm in there.
This corner, asking her to use the wall to push. Maybe even looking for the triangle.
Looks for an armbar.
Now it is an armbar attempt, under a minute left in the second round.
You have it.
Now Smith looking for that arm.
Arm is extended.
Belly down armbar attempt by Smith.
I think she's wiggling that elbow out, but I can't see the angle from here.
I can't see it either.
I know, it looks like the elbow's still buried, but she's using it to roll up to top position. Oh, nice.
This is a crazy
great corner working. Yeah, unbelievable position.
Okay,
here,
the elbow's free now. She's still on top. She can go for the other side.
Right. Looks like she's going for an omoplata.
Yeah.
But she's blocked.
Yeah.
Now she's going for a toehold.
I love that. Just fire one thing after another, right?
She's like Dean Malenko.
Dean Malenko, wow. The man of a thousand pounds.
Yep.
Now it's Smith still looking for that arm, but great job by Maia and a great round. Close. Casey and ooh. Esther doing a great job, but enough of the promotion here. We've got to get back to this brawl in the third round. Unbelievable toe-to-toe action. Now, this is how you start a third round. Oh, head kick by Maia.
I'm enjoying myself too much to say good words.
It's unbelievable the pace that these two ladies have maintained. And again, Leslie Smith making her debut at 125 pounds. Elbow, Maia right there, though, with the jab. I know it looks like she may have been poked in the eye. And while we have a chance, we'll give a shout out to the Feral Few, who've also helped with production. And hey, Cassie Rodish, an Invicta FC veteran, her daughter Riley is celebrating her 9th birthday today. So happy birthday,
kiddo.
Riley. Hope you're enjoying this fight as much as we are. Although, isn't it past your bedtime?
Well, we're going to pick right back up.
Yeah. Darn you, wide poker. There's a good 1-2 combination executed by Smith. Maia coming forward. They're just continuing to stay in the pocket, mixing up their striking attack.
Oh my goodness.
I mean, this just defies description.
Hook, everything. They're throwing everything.
They're both landing such hard, clean shots, and neither one's just, yeah.
It's unbelievable.
I'm not moving
much. I mean, Leslie Smith comes from the Cesar Gracie camp. You can see why. I mean, the volume punching a la Nick and Nate Diaz is amazing.
And you figure that, you know, with the weight cut, you know, she'd slow down, but I haven't seen any signs of
her. Oh, man. She staggered Maia with that elbow. Now she is a force here at 125 and now continues to take the fight to Maia along the fence. Maia needs to circle away. Valerie trying to fight.
Goodness.
Catches a kick and looks for the trip takedown and gets it.
Look at Leslie's trying to climb up on her back.
Yeah, she's looking for the submission.
It's like an arm triangle.
She actually has a sweet. Oh no, I'm sorry, Maia passed over. Excuse me.
Smart. Good great takedown. The right time by Maia.
Yeah, she was getting staggered. She's getting a little bit overwhelmed.
An amazing bout here at flyweight between Jennifer Maia, and Leslie Smith, and now Maia
going for a dunk.
Locking up.
Yeah.
She doesn't have it though.
I don't know if she's in the right position for leverage right there. She's got to climb that left arm a little bit higher, I think, or else get her hips out so she can move to the side more.
Back and forth, the ebb and flow of mixed martial arts. You are seeing it on full display in this bout between Jennifer Maia and Leslie Smith at her 125-pound debut, now in the half guard. Elbow attack from Smith in top position. And now looking for, from this vantage point, looks like this guillotine, right?
Yeah, arm in.
Top guillotine.
Under 2 minutes remaining in the fight.
Really good position to strike from. It looks like she wants a finish. She wants a submission finish right here. I imagine this be exhausting for Maia on the bottom though.
I'm glad I'm not always the one that starts the round. Just kidding.
Oh, no.
Just kidding. 9 seconds left in the third round. A great fight. Mauro Ranallo along with Julie Kenzie King Mo. We hope you are enjoying it wherever you may be watching. On pay-per-view, still plenty of great action to come. But man, we've seen some fantastic fights already tonight. And this one is right up there.
Elbow there.
Into the final minute of the fight, Leslie Smith continues to work from top position. And now gets mouth, or not yet, but enough to get ground and pound, and she's going to work on Maia, making a statement here with 45 seconds left. Maia forced to surrender her back. And now looking for that choke.
Smith is strong.
The pace has been incredible. 30 seconds left in the fight.
I wish they had CompuStrike or something. Because this is breaking
records. Hey, CompuBox doesn't wish to be here. Their thumbs and everything, the blisters, that's okay. But no, you're right. The stats would be amazing for this fight.
Oh, wow.
And
nice.
Ground and pound.
To hit from right there.
And Maia absorbing all the shots. Final 10 seconds. Smith looking to try to put away Maia, but clock is going to run out. A terrific flyweight fight, and what a debut at 125.
So here are the totals. Judges Geary and Miller agree, 30-27. Swanberg, 29-28. All three for your winner by unanimous decision. In her flyweight debut, Leslie, the Peacemaker Smith!
Congratulations to Leslie Smith, but hats off to Jennifer Maia.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, from the Ameristar Casino Hotel here in Kansas City, Missouri, it's time for your main event of the evening. Five rounds for the Invicta FC Flyweight Championship of the World. Sanctioned by the Missouri Office of Athletics, Executive Director Tim Lukenhoff, Kateside Physicians, Dr. Rance McLean, and Dr. Kenneth Butler Taylor. Your timekeeper is Dr. Marsha Champion. Your three judges scoring this World Championship matchup on a 10-point must system are Henry Geary, Jackson Harper, and Ross Swanberg. And the referee, when the bell sounds, is Big John McCarthy. Introducing first, fighting to my left, out of the blue corner, she is a mixed martial artist, standing 5'9" tall. Her official weight, 124.75 pounds, with an outstanding professional record consisting of 6 wins, 3 losses, with 1 draw, from Pleasant Hill, California. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the challenger, Leslie the Peacemaker Smith. And her opponent, fighting to my right, out of the red corner, she is a mixed martial artist, standing 5'4" tall. Her official weight, 124.5 pounds. Her record is impressive, 8 victories against 2 defeats, representing and fighting out of Bettendorf, Iowa. She is the reigning, defending Invicta FC Flyweight Champion of the World, Barb, Little Warrior Honchak. And the referee, here to give instructions, Big John McCarthy.
Connor, with the rules, protect yourself at all times, obey my commands at all times. Fight clean, fight hard for fair. If you want to touch gloves, do it now. Step back, good luck to both of you.
The World Championship main event between Honchak and Smith. The closing odds for this one, Leslie Smith the favorite at minus 190. The comeback on Barb Honchak at plus 150. Michael Chavello, King Mo Lawal, and Misha Tate with you from the Ameristar Hotel and Casino in Kansas City, Missouri. The main event of Invicta Fighting Championship 7.
That's it. Leslie is a really big 125er. She fought at 135 previously, and I mean, she cuts a tremendous amount of weight, so there may have only been a 1 pound advantage to her last night, but I guarantee you there's a bigger weight difference tonight of the two in the cage.
Double jab from Honchak early on, goes to the body, then upstairs with the right hand. Jab again from Honchak, then hooks the punch. Inside thigh kick from Smith, trying to lock onto a Muay Thai clinch. Honchak grapples up with her, drives a knee into the midsection. Looking for the underhook here, Smith drives a knee off her left leg.
Smith is definitely a fan favorite fighter because she's so busy. I mean, she just, there's never a dull moment with that girl. She's like the Energizer Bunny, the Terminator, and I mean, I don't know what, all in combination. Very busy girl.
2 fight of the night bonuses so far for Leslie Smith. Now pressed against the cage by Honchak.
If Honchak wants to win this fight, she needs to figure out a way to slow Leslie Smith down. This is a perfect way. Even if you get a takedown, Leslie Smith's so active, but while keeping her cage against the, keeping her pinned up against the cage is a perfect thing to do.
Overhook on that right arm from Leslie Smith. Nice knee to the belly button. Honchak returns the favor. Trying to punch her way out of the grapple here, and does so Leslie Smith. Honchak circles into the right side of Smith. Probing jab to the sternum. Oh, nice Nice. Looked like she was going for the overhand right. Switched it to an uppercut instead, Barb Honchak. Honchak again. Bolo punch off the right hand.
Same thing with Jennifer.
Good left hook upstairs by Honchak. Moving well so far here in the first round with her hands, Misha.
Yeah, absolutely. They're filling each other out. And Barb is using those crisp, clean jabs right down the middle to set up the rest of her striking.
Both women tucking the chin. Uppercuts again here from Honchak. Just past the halfway mark of the opening round. Jab needed a right hand, outside thigh kick from Smith, sticks the jab between the eyes, double leg from Honchak to no avail.
And I'll tell you this, Leslie's doing a great job of defending these takedowns. Maybe she trained with someone that helped to prepare for this. I don't know.
Actually, I did get to train with Leslie for about a week and a half. She came out to Vegas and helped me in my preparation for my fight coming up, and me vice versa, having a little bit of a wrestling style. We definitely worked on a few things, but both these girls are really great girls. I've noticed that Leslie's doing a great job of hiking the arms up of Barb off of her legs, and then she's able to work pummeling out of that position and getting off of the cage where she wants to be, and out here to use the striking.
Barb Honchak with a tank down of Leslie Smith, trying to pass and go to side control. Right leg still stuck in though. Scooping the punch under the right armpit of Smith. 1 minute 15 remains in the first round.
That was a great time to take down by Barb. And here now she has what I call far side wrist ride, or the deputy sheriff. She's controlling that far side wrist, and she's going to look to put some ground and pound on Leslie Smith.
Barb Honchak, top position on Smith, rolls onto her back now, looking for a submission. Body triangle locked on here by Honchak. Where does Leslie Smith go from here, Misha?
She actually did a great job. She took away the post, the barb. She wants to continue to do that and try to continue to shake her down in front of her. She's going to want to pull on that knee and continue to try to get Barb down into the guard position rather than on her back. So essentially she wants to hula hoop her off of her.
Body triangle broken. Will Honchak try to reset it? Under 20 seconds remains here in the round.
This is some high-level stuff right here.
There's a lot of work going on, lower body and upper body here by both of these girls. One to try to maintain control, the other to try to get out.
And that's how the round ends. One down in our main event. Second round of our main event championship fight. Big John McCarthy to get us underway. Honchak staring down Smith from across the cage. Early jab from Leslie Smith. Honchak goes jab hook combination. Jab two from Smith. Uppercut hook combination from Honchak. She likes that combo mode.
Yeah, and usually I don't really like leading the uppercut, but the fact that she's leading the uppercut and landing the shots, I think a lot of this comes because she's landing so many clean shots. She's feinting, or she's just giving the motion to her shoulders before she goes.
Honchak trying to get on the inside, the long arms of Leslie Smith again with the right hand there, Honchak. Smith not throwing anything here, goes for an inside leg kick and a right hand down the center. Combination from Smith, didn't find it with those three punches. Front kick from Honchak, nicely placed, here the uppercut. Honchak looking sharp with her striking, Misha.
Absolutely, yeah. She had a beautifully timed push kick there, closing the distance again and working for a takedown off of the cage.
Overhook on the arm there from Smith, on the left arm of Honchak.
Honchak's very powerful. She's a powerhouse, and because she does come from that wrestling background, she really uses her hips well, her head positioning well. She's always in a good position. She's very, very rarely out of position.
Double leg here from Honchak. Gets the takedown. Nicely done from Barb.
Great penetration right there. Great timing.
Barb Honchak, top position on Leslie Smith with 3 minutes,
Punch
5 remaining
right
in the second round, set for 5.
Punch in the back right there. Shoot on, shoot on. Full guard. Full guard. Full guard right
the
there.
The corner of Leslie Smith are begging for it, a pull guard, not to be though, as Honchak goes to side control.
I'll do it, I'll do it.
I like that, what she did there. She walked over the cage. She got control of the head. I prefer that personally than pulling guard, where she could be stuck on bottom and held down by a really solid wrestler.
Knees from both women. Honchak trying to pull the head down into the meet and greet.
Leslie trying to throw elbows over the top there.
Good folding knee from Leslie Smith. Honchak drops down to a single leg.
This is a grueling pace right here.
Both women have not slowed down for a breath for 2.5 rounds so far.
Right, and this is scheduled for five-minute rounds, so it's a good pace.
Nice.
These girls are pushing right here.
Right hand from Leslie Smith. Honchak resets now. Fakes with the right. Fakes again does Honchak. Overhand right. Completely off target for Honchak, and Smith comes forward, eats a hook, and gets backed up. Outside leg kick from Honchak. Smith's got to start putting that jab in her face now. Inside leg kick from Honchak. Counter right hand from Leslie Smith.
And that was a nice short left hook. She tightened it up and she realized Barb was so close, landed right on the chin.
I like it. Even though Honchak is powerful and strong, she's throwing a lot of volume too. She's throwing her combos, and I like that.
Honchak, some dirty boxing, throws those uppercuts again. Honchak on the outside here. Smith trying to cut off her footwork.
One knee, one, two knee. Get over here, hands.
Let's go, let's go. Both women sucking the chin, looking through the brow. Hook again from Honchak.
I would love to see Leslie go for a takedown of her own, just so that Barb has something more to think about.
Good call, Misha.
And that's what I would be telling Leslie from the corner if I was them, when I go in between rounds, to set up a shot.
Definitely.
Oh, toe-to-toe! And it was Leslie Smith who got the better of the exchange on that occasion. And another right hand from Smith. Circles, clockwise. Honchak with the jab. Smith's gotten off some good strikes in this round. Smith comes forward again, takes that inside thigh kick. Another one, just the toes flipping there for Honchak. Honchak to the body, then hooks up to the head. Muay Thai clinch from Smith. Gets off a couple of knees, those will score for her. Clash of heads there.
Confident just being able to take Leslie down at will.
And it looked like for a second she was going to attempt to take down of her own last round.
Same one. How is the same thing?
It is MMA, you know, you've got to mix it up sometimes and throw the element of surprise in there.
Body shot from Honchak, then tries to loop the right hand. The work rate of both of these women, superb. Uppercut from Smith. Honchak trying to fold her with a knee. Jab from Barb Honchak. Jab to Honchak, gets countered. Solid left hand from Leslie Smith. And Honchak puts her against the cage. Knees from Honchak, trying to pull the head down, but the chest will suffice for now. Smith into right hand, Muay Thai clinch from Honchak. And Smith gets down there.
Some nice dirty boxing by these girls here.
This is where Smith tends to turn it up and get strong. Mm-hmm. And both women are fighting very hard. This might be a nasty scene from American Horror Story 3. I know y'all watched that. I watched it too, but these girls are really fighting hard.
Faking here, Smith. It was a 3-2 combination at the end of the day. Honchak now faking off her right side.
See that level change? Yeah, the level change and then the hook. Essentially, she's making Leslie think, hey, I could shoot at any moment, and getting her to drop her hands a little bit and then coming over the top with punches.
Oh, Leslie Smith, beautiful left hand. This is with a high right round kick. Gets out of the way of the left hook to Honchak. Honchak again faking. just keeping Leslie Smith on her toes.
Oh, a nice kick.
She connects with the neck of Honchak, and my word, can Honchak take him off? Beautifully executed round kick off the left leg from Leslie Smith.
That was nice.
Right elbow from Smith. They break off now, almost at the halfway point of this third round. Jab two from Leslie Smith.
If I were Leslie, I would stick to mostly those head kicks every once in a while, because it seemed like earlier in the round when she threw a knee and also when she's throwing the leg kicks that Honchak's trying to time those for takedowns.
Nice rib kick from Honchak, left the leg out there. Leslie Smith tries to capitalize. High knee from Leslie. Good jab from Leslie Smith.
And it's weird because usually Leslie throws a lot of head kicks out, following the fence in the hands and combo.
High lift round again. Leslie's seen that Barb is tending to drift off onto her right side. Knee to the inside thigh. Over the leg here from Smith and a crossing sock to the elbow. Nicely done. This is Leslie Smith, I feel, gaining the upper hand on the striking now, Misha.
I completely agree. She seems to have found her timing and her range. She's starting to understand when Barb Honchak closes the distance a little bit, she's able to time those elbows pretty nicely off of it and the knees. And when they're out open, she seems to be getting the better of the exchanges at this point.
Looping right hand from Leslie Smith. 1 minute 35 remains in a third round battle. Overhook on the right arm here from Smith. Throws the knee. Corner of Smith are calling for the knees up the right. She throws it, but it's blocked by the forearm of Honchak as she drifts back to center game. Jab from Honchak. Double jab right hand. No starch behind it, though, from Barb Honchak.
Honchak seems to have success when she makes Leslie go backwards.
Uppercut left hook here. Favored combination of the fight from Barb Honchak. Smith training jabs. Body shot, belly button through the back from Leslie Smith. Fork right hand, outside leg hit to the back leg, missed the target, but Leslie Smith trying to change it up a little. Throw a few surprises. Honchak wants another takedown, gets another takedown. Now can Leslie turn this into an omoplata? She does indeed. Shoulder lock on that left shoulder of Honchak.
Honchak looking to step over. Oh, that was a nice reversal by Leslie. You know, Leslie does train at Gracie Jiu-Jitsu, so her grappling is certainly sharp as well.
And it's now Leslie Smith inside the close guard of Barb Honchak. Corner warning her to beware of the guillotine. She pops the head up, lands the elbow. Fantastic round. Back again, staring her down. Gloves turned out from Honchak to catch the jab.
Right there, always there, always there. Always
inside there. Leg kick, a nice one from Honchak. Circles off clockwise. Good inside leg kick again. And goes to the outside leg. That one to the outside of the knee. Some leg work early on here from Barb Honchak.
She's looking sharp right now. But the problem with this is, when Leslie Smith has gone backwards, that's when she gets in the roll. If I were Honchak, I would try to reverse the situation and make Leslie go backwards.
Smith threads the jab. Just falls short for it. Jab two from Smith, inside leg kick. Smith tries to cut off the cage. Left hook uppercut again from Honchak. There's the fake from Smith. Honchak just measuring with the jab. Step across inside leg kick. A chance for Smith to counter, but to no avail. Honchak's landing those kicks to the lead knee of Smith, and they will take their toll.
Slow you down.
Wild looping left hand there from Honchak. Shoots in. Another takedown. She's finding the takedowns a little easy, Misha.
Yeah, she's getting that back heel trip really well. Leslie's looking to push the push the head down.
Honchak.
Stand up, but
Honchak just pulled her straight backwards and is trying to take her back now.
Shot to the eye there from Honchak. Smith didn't like it. That right hand loose again for Honchak. Where does Leslie Smith go from here, Misha?
She's got the far side underhook there. I'd like her to see her continue to use it, but she gave it up. She's going to try to do like a hip sweep right there, but Barb's really well aware of it. Barb has great hips, like I said, so I think that's going to be a difficult move for Leslie to pull off there, as we see her struggling with that.
It's like a modified Peterson, but when you can't do that with people that have a strong wrestling base, it's kind of hard because we're familiar to.
Right now, is free here for Barb Honchak.
Right now, what I would do, yeah, because Leslie, exactly, bring that left arm out. There you go. Now she can turn and face and work to stand up.
Leslie Smith back to her feet. Honchak with the high knee tries to put her against the cage here. Looks to drop down levels again. Lock onto a single leg perhaps here, Barb Honchak. They got 2 minutes 10 remaining in the penultimate round, our main event of the Invicta Fighting Championship number 7.
And Barb needs to step through and win the pipe. Step to left on the pipe.
The battle of will here. Leslie is trying to pull Miriam, she's trying to pull Barb up with everything that she has. I know they release enough, they're off the cage now. So.
Jab from Leslie Smith. Honchak. Again, the palms turn out to catch that jab. She'll try and counter with a jab of her own, then the hook and the uppercut. Smith jabbing. Good front kick. Dug the balls of the feet in, splayed the toes nicely. Cup munching knee there from Honchak. Both women trade jabs. It was Honchak who fell short.
So or not, right, kind of on the outside of, over on the outside of Honchak's eye from the right hand. Right.
This is just such a close fight with 1 minute to go in the fourth round of fight. Honchak wants a takedown again. Not on this occasion. Crossing elbow from Smith just a little too late, and Honchak gets back to center cage.
Now, what Leslie needs to do is to kind of throw Barb's takedown attempts off, is bend her legs a little bit. Get a little slightly lower stance. Because she's kind of upright in a European stance a little bit. It's easy for her to get to her legs.
Straight punching here from Leslie Smith, trying to back out Barb Honchak. Honchak on the outside, circles up counterclockwise. Smith cuts off that movement, so Honchak goes the other way. Muay Thai clinching a knee here from Honchak. And again, this one to the midsection. And they break off. Skip up front kick off the lead leg from Honchak. Goes to the inside lead five. Honchak faking with the right hand. Connects. End of the round. One more round to go. Come down to the next 5 minutes for Barb Honchak and Leslie Smith. Both women open up with the jabs. Good stiff cross there from Honchak. Inside leg kick Honchak. I love the way she gauges the distance by probing those hands forward. Again, the palms turned outward. Left hook, leg kick combination. Good technique there from Barb. Smith trying to cut off her footwork. Barb looking for the tie clinch. Smith had none of it. Front kick, spinning back elbow. Right hand down the tube from Honchak. Honchak finding some combinations here. Two clean punches from Leslie Smith. Good outside leg kick from Honchak. Honchak looks to be the busier of the two here, Misha, at the start of this fifth and final round.
Yep, she's looking to push the pace. She wants to probably get this fight to the ground again. I think she feels like she's dominant there.
Overhooking that right arm, and Honchak gets it out of there. Both women go back to center cage. 3:45 remains.
One thing I will say is when Barb realizes that she doesn't have the takedown there, she's willing to disengage and set up a new clean shot.
Uppercut, right cross from Leslie Smith. Smith trying to plow forward. Honchak constantly on the move. Step through knee from Smith. The corner liked it and connected to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. Knee again there from Leslie Smith. Scoops out the attempted front kick. Overhand right from Honchak. Mo, Honchak's round or Smith's round?
Right now, Honchak looks busy, but to me, it seems like Smith is landing the shots. Now, the takedown. It's definitely pushed things in Barb's favor.
Half guard position for Barb Honchak. That takedown has been a recipe for success so far in this fight. What does Smith need to do here, Misha?
She almost has a butterfly sweep there. Yep, that's exactly what I was figuring she was trying to do. Back on her feet.
Honchak's got a cut. It may be under her left eye by the looks of it. Everything, Leslie! The corner of Leslie Smith saying everything, Leslie. We hit the halfway mark of the fifth and final round. Underhooks here for Honchak. Throws some knees, crossing elbow from Smith. Skip up front kick from Honchak. A real throwdown, duke out battle here between these two ladies on the feet. Uppercut, backs her off to the right hand of Smith.
Now
sloppy shot for a double.
A good time for that head kick attempt again.
Good call, Misha. Overhand elbow from Honchak, nowhere near the distance though. Wild uppercut from him. Leslie Smith almost took out the ring lights. And it is a cut under the left eye of Barb Honchak. She wipes away the blood. Big uppercut. Rock the head back of Leslie Smith. Overhand right from Honchak. Real power salvos from Barb Honchak. And again with the right hand. Leslie's trying to set her own right cross here. Uppercut left hand it is from Leslie Smith. Honchak wants to take her down, drives her against the cage. Okay, Misha, with a minute 10 remaining, what are you telling Leslie Smith to do?
She's got to push forward. Flurries, I would try to get her to set up that left head kick again and look for a knockout finish. You know, I've been saying the whole time it would have been great to see a takedown out of her, but it may be a little late in the game for her to be looking for just that. I'd be wanting to say, hey, let's try to knock this girl out.
Under a minute remaining, Honchak again with that takedown, Mo.
It's effective, double leg to an outside step, outside trip. Usually, we don't, you know, wrestlers, we really don't do that technique because with different stance, but in MMA, it works real well.
Works well because they're standing so much taller, yep. So you can have a lot of room to get that leg through a trip.
Leslie Smith looking for this right arm of Barb Honchak. 25 seconds to go in the championship fight. Honchak bleeding, keeps Leslie Smith on her back. Smith puts her inside her full guard now. Honchak's trying to push her back against the cage, goes to half guard. Final 10 seconds. Barb Honchak in half guard. Smith giving her back now, trying to get to her feet, Leslie Smith. And that's how the fight ends. Five rounds of awesomeness.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five championship rounds, we go to the scorecards. All three judges, Wah Swanberg, Henry Greery, and Jackson Harper, have the contest the same. 49-46 for your winner by unanimous decision. And still, the Invicta FC flyweight champion of the world, Barb the Warrior Honchak.